नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, माय नेम इज जेविंस डॉक्टर नीरज धोलिया, फैकल्टी ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड वेटरनरी साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ, वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी, जयपुर। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ प्रैक्टिकल सॉरी अ सेशन दैट इज द विंड एनर्जी एडवांटेज डिसएडवांटेज, विंड मिल्स एंड इट्स टाइप्स। ओके, सो व्हाट इज द विंड एनर्जी? ओके, सो विंड इज द वर्ल्ड्स फास्टेस्ट ग्रोइंग एनर्जी सोर्स टुडे, and it has been retaining this position continuously for the last 5 years. The global wind power capacity has increased by a factor of 4.2 during the last 5 years. The total global installed capacity is around 39,434 megawatt in 2004. So installed capacity in different regions is shown or is discussed below. That country Germany have the installed capacity is 14,609 in 2004. In United States it is 6,352, and in India it is 2,120 megawatt. So air in motion is called wind, and the wind on the earth surface are caused primarily by the unequal heating of the land and water by the sun. So the differences in temperature gradients include induce the circulation of air from one zone to another. So winds are caused on earth due to the absorption of solar energy on earth and its atmosphere. The pressure and temperature gradients causes wind or wind flow. So also the rotation of earth about its axis and its movement around the sun causes the flow of wind. So principally it is said that the difference in the pressure, the air pressure, difference in the air pressure causes the air flow. Okay, so the energy derived from wind velocity is wind energy. Okay, so if someone asks that what is the wind energy, then you can say that the energy which we can derive from the its velocity is the wind energy. So it is a non-conventional type of energy and which is renewable with suitable devices. So this energy can be used as a perennial source of energy. Wind energy is obtained by obtained with the help of windmill. So the minimum wind speed of 10 kmph is considered to be useful for working windmills for agriculture purpose. So along the sea coast, the hilly areas, windmills are likely to be most successful in Karnataka, in Maharashtra, and in Gujarat. So the wind energy over earth is estimated to be 1.6 into 10 power 7 megawatt, which is equivalent to the energy consumed. So, but the wind energy is available in dilute form. The conversion machines are large. The wind energy varies from time to time and place to place. So due to this reason, some storage facility is required. The kinetic energy of wind is converted into useful shaft power by windmills. The general applications of windmills are cutting grain, grinding, generation of power, etc. So in India, wind speed lies between 5 to 20 kmph. So kilometer per hour, okay, kmph. So the high wind velocity is seasonal. The wind energy, if useful for power generation, it will be uncertain to generate power. In India, wind power can be used for lifting water in rural areas, for drinking and for irrigation purposes. So there are various factors which affects the wind, that is the latitude of the place. Latitude means the axial position on the earth. Then altitude of the place, altitude means the height from the surface of the earth, the altitude, the topography of the place, the scale of the hour, month of the year, that all things are affected or affects the wind or wind velocity. So the suitable places For the windmills are the first the offshores and on the sea coast. An average value of the cost is 2,400 kilowatt hour per meter square per year. And mountains, an average value is 1,600 kilowatt hour per meter square per year. And in the plains, an average value is 750 kilowatt hour per meter square per year. So what are the places that are unsuitable for the windmills? So the humid equatorial regions, there is virtually no wind energy. The warm windy countries, wind energy may not be useful because of the frequency of cyclones. Okay, so there are basically two types of windmills we will discuss. The windmill is, what is windmill? Windmill is a machine of wind energy conversion. So a wind turbine converts the kinetic energy of the wind's motion to the mechanical energy transmitted by the shaft. A generator further converts it to the electrical energy by generating the electricity. So as I told that there are two types of the windmills. One is the vertical axis windmill and second is the horizontal axis windmill. Okay, so there are examples of the vertical axis windmills are the Sevenius or S-type windmill, which is put at the places where the wind velocity is low. Then another is the Darius windmill, that is put at the place where the wind velocity is high. So both of the type of the windmills are the example of the vertical axis windmill. Okay. Then second is the horizontal axis windmill, and the examples are the single blade windmill, double blade windmill, okay, multiple blade windmills, bicycle, multi-blade type, that is snail type. So these are the example of the horizontal axis windmill. Okay. So the vertical axis machine are of simple design as compared to the horizontal axis. The axis of rotation of vertical axis wind turbine is vertical to the ground and almost perpendicular to the wind direction. So these turbines can receive wind from any direction, and hence the complicated yaw devices can be eliminated. The generator and the gearbox of such systems can be housed at the ground level, which makes the tower design simple and more economical. And moreover, the maintenance of these turbines can be done at the ground level. The major disadvantages of vertical axis machines are that these turbines usually not self-starting. Okay, so you need an additional mechanism to push and start the turbine. So this problem is associated with the vertical axis type windmills. Okay, then second is the horizontal axis type windmill. Okay, so horizontal axis wind turbines have their axis of rotation horizontal to the ground, horizontal to the ground and almost parallel to the wind stream. So most of the commercial wind turbines fall under this category, and horizontal axis machines have some distinct disadvantages such as low cut in speed and the easy furling. In general, they show relatively high power coefficient, and however, the generator and gearbox of these machines are to be placed over the tower, which makes its design more complex and expensive also. So depending on the number of blades, horizontal axis wind turbines are further classified in the single bladed, two bladed or double bladed, three bladed and multi-bladed windmills. Okay, so single blade turbines are cheaper due to saving one blade material. The drag losses are also minimum for these turbines. However, to balance the blades, the counter weight has to be placed opposite to the hub. So single blade designs are not very popular due to problem in the balancing and visual acceptability. So two-bladed rotors also have these drawbacks, but to lesser extent. Most of the present commercial turbines used for electricity generation have three blades. Now, what are the advantages of the wind energy? So it is, first of all, it is renewable source of energy. So it is, again, second is the, it is non-polluting and no adverse influence on the environment. So environment friendly. Then no fuel and transportation is required. Okay, the electricity is also consumed locally. So the cost of electricity under low production is comparatively low, rather than the other devices. Although some disadvantages are also there. Okay, so the available wind energy is dilute and fluctuating in nature. So this makes the output or the your product variable. Okay, if wind is sufficient, then you will get the sufficient energy, or if it is not, then it is not at that much. So unlike water energy, the wind energy requires storage capacity because of its irregularity. Okay, though wind energy operating machines are noisy in operation, so this is again a problem. And wind power systems have a relatively high overall weight, and for large systems, a weight of 110 kg per kilowatt has been estimated. So that is very weighty system. Okay, so then large areas are required for wind energy. You cannot place it in the areas where the populations resides. Okay. Then you have to put it on the higher altitude and like the mountains and the upper areas. So the present windmills are neither maintenance free nor practically reliable. The present windmills are no, neither maintenance free nor practically reliable. So these are the disadvantages related with the wind energy. So this was all about the wind energy. So hope you are satisfied with this little session. If you have any query, please write in the comment box. I will reply and resolve your query. And this session is powered by Digital Version 2, Jyoti Vidyapeeth, Tumi University, Jaipur. Thank you.